The world of sort of mousing around and keyboarding around and typing will feel as alien as it does to Gen Z to sort of use DOS. So I'm David Weston, maybe better known as Dwizzle. I'm a corp vice president at Microsoft. I lead the operating system security group, so always building new security technologies and all the different operating systems from Windows to Server to Azure, even Xbox. I also lead a penetration testing team that finds security flaws in the same products. In 5 years, I strongly believe you'll be able to hire a security expert. That's actually underneath the hood an AI agent. But the way you interact with it will be a lot like you do humans today. You'll talk to them on Teams, they'll join meetings, you'll send them emails, you'll assign them tasks. And so in the daily work life, that will set folks up to do less of, I'll call it the toil work, the work we don't love today, and allow them to focus on what humans are good at: ideation, creativity, vision, connecting with other humans on what products are necessary. These agents will be net amplifiers and enable us to do things that we could only dream of just a few years ago. I think we will do less with our eyes and more talking to our computers. And I truly believe the future version of Windows and other Microsoft operating systems will interact in both in a multimodal way. The computer will be able to see what we see, hear what we hear, and we can talk to it and ask it to do much more sophisticated things. So I think this will be a much more natural form of communication. I believe what will look completely different about security is a couple things. The first is I think customers will prefer and migrate towards what I would call appliance level security. What I mean by that is your dishwasher today, it does one function, you hit a button and it works every time. It's not extensible, it's not general purpose, you can't install apps on it necessarily, it just works. It's clear there's a vision for moving forward where it just works from a security perspective, and I think more computers will move towards that direction. The second thing that I think will look completely different is what it means to have a security team today. Staffing an expert cybersecurity team, as well as purchasing just all the software and deploying it, is outside of the reach of many small and medium-sized businesses. I think they will have a team of software agents and really build a full sort of corporate security team, even for the smallest business. And then the third thing I think is a clear trend in my mind is we will have unlimited compute in the form of quantum. We know that'll change the security landscape dramatically. We need to get ahead of that, or simply attackers will become asymmetric and we'll be in what we would call a trough in defense. So I think that's a scary thought, but for me, it's a focusing thought, which is, you know, part of my job is to predict these things. So this is one of the reasons in Windows, we are implementing what we call post-quantum or quantum safe encryption now. But my push to the customers, the people that use Windows is, use products like Windows 11 and turn on quantum-resistant technologies that are there today to prepare for this eventuality now. The Windows Resiliency Initiative is Microsoft's effort to make Windows and all variants of the operating system more resilient in the event of a failure. This includes things like the ability to recover systems remotely, no matter where you are, without sending folks out in cars and sort of manually restoring systems. It includes us working with partners in our ecosystem to share our best practices, our technologies and tools to make the software that makes the entire Windows ecosystem more resilient to failures. I think we're already seeing today, there are some nation-state actors who have been using things like deepfake technology and to actually get jobs in financial companies here in the United States for the express and sole purpose of becoming insiders to either steal IP or money. When that happens, you can no longer trust a face or a voice, and you absolutely need to have some mechanism for integrity. Actually, in Windows today, we've started to implement provenance standards for things like the Associated Press and others who maybe in election time, et cetera, need to prove that where the source of an image is and that it's unaltered. The last that is really, to me, one of the most important is a concept we call memory safety. Today, roughly 70 to 75% of the vulnerabilities that you have to patch are buffer overruns or computational errors leading to corruption of computer memory. The way memory safety will protect customers is really twofold, or benefit customers. One is 70, 75% of attacks will just no longer apply. The second thing that I think it is really beneficial is a lot of our time today as IT professionals is spent patching things. If we have 70 to 75% less things to patch, imagine what we could do by harvesting that. I would say, look at your risks today that you don't have solutions for and carry those for 5 years. Because you have 5 years to make progress on those. Getting rid of your passwords, figuring out what your strategy is, how to upgrade to the latest operating systems and get on a faster cadence around those. Those are perpetual problems. And so you're not going to be able to deal with the 5 years from now problems if you don't have a plan to deal with today. I would focus on devices across my network from infrastructure to edge to, you know, computing devices on maximum prevention technology. I think the costs and variability in the event of a breach are just way too high. And the cost for getting highly resilient hardware-software combinations are so much cheaper than that. I think we have to find ways to just iterate much quicker on our software and hardware deployments. As much as we're here talking about all the cool trends, frankly, my 20-year cybersecurity career, the fundamentals stay the same. Patch, perform, you know, what I'd call cyber hygiene, password rotation. In our world, maybe that means getting rid of passwords and moving to biometrics, et cetera. But the basics still stop 98% of attacks. 20 years ago, that was true. 20 years before that was true. And so focusing on those basics and figuring out how modern technology, AI agents, can get you to those basics faster, easier, more cost-effectively, I think will continue to be a winning strategy. The changes in computing that will make folks happier are, again, this is a common theme for me, which is removing the toil. The things that I don't like are generating spreadsheets, doing expense reports, making sure that my schedule is clear, or picking the optimal places in meetings. Now, I didn't get into technology to do that. I got into technology to build products that are going to improve people's lives. And so if there's a low-hanging fruit that's available today, it's 10, 20, 30, 40% of our time can be reclaimed away from the things that we didn't sign up for, but are just part of that, you know, standard day-to-day life. And if we can reclaim 30 to 40% of our lives times 365 days a year, what's possible?